Yo, what's good, YouTube? My name is Yuri Uchiha. Welcome back to some more Dragon Ball FighterZ Ranked Matches. And hopping in with my boy, SSJ4 Gogeta, who I haven't played in quite some time, not gonna lie. He's kind of, you could say, one of my mains, but I've always had him, like, as a B team, like, someone to go to as a backup. But, yeah, kind of playing him now. One of the characters that ended up getting nerfed, because he didn't get any actual changes to him, but the meter game nerf, which I don't know if, you know, I mean, it's a nerf, you know what I mean? But, like, he got the 25% meter game nerf, as opposed to the top three, who got the 50%. So it's affecting him, but it's not affecting him as much as the others. So I still think he's in a very good spot right now. Probably still a top five character in this game, no lie. But yeah, and on day three of the daily upload streak, at the end of the last video, I said that I was going to start daily uploading, and I want to go for as long as I can. Not even going to think about it, just going to, you know, do what I got to do, because I'm really trying to be on the grind for real, and I'm really trying to be on the grind for real. So yeah, that's something I really want to set out and do. And wow, 2H too early. All right, thankfully he didn't punish us when he could have. And what's going on with my confirms right now? I have no idea. But yeah, it's something I really want to set out and do, because I know that I'm capable of doing it. And yeah, so here we are with day three, and we're gonna continue, like I said, getting right back into the swing of things. Like I said in the previous video, I haven't been as consistent as I wanted to be. And, you know, this is one way of being consistent as I want to be, which is daily uploading, man. Something that I've always thought about doing, but I just never committed to it. But definitely want to now, so yeah. Had a lot of control to start off this match, but kind of letting it go a little bit. He did it out. Oh, he unfortunately... Good 2H. Unfortunately for him, he didn't get the confirm off of it, but it doesn't matter because we're still exploding right here and still losing out on SSJ for Gogeta and our level 1 sparking, but we can recover from this. It's fine. I had no idea what was going on. I feel like Jiren should have honestly been dead a lot sooner. Did I just... I'm supposed to teleport right behind my opponent right there, and I just... Okay, I'm lost. I teleported right in front of Jiren when I'm supposed to teleport behind him right there. Like, I'm actually, like, at a loss for words right there. Because, okay, what? I mean, what's, is it really a UD video if I'm not dropping combos? Let's be for real. Is it really a UD video if I'm not dropping combos? As I've given myself the title of Drop Combo King, so. But yeah. I'm gonna wake up Mash, and he backed away. Overhead. Shining Slash always be working, man. You definitely gotta mix it up here and there so that your opponent doesn't adapt to it, but it's still like a really, really fast move, you know what I mean? Which is something I love about my boy Trunks. But yeah, down to the Vegito, and again, we do be having character leads and then letting that slip like real fast. But yeah, I'm doing level 3 with Trunks. I probably should have maybe done it with 21 so I could get some of the Saiyan steals, but it's okay. It's gonna work out. And he ended up getting hit by the second overhead, and that's gonna be us. That's gonna be us taking game one right here. Off to a solid start. Not too bad. But yeah, I was saying though that I have a really bad habit of letting my leads go. I don't even want to call it a habit. It's like, it just happens. And I can't even explain to you why that really is. It just happens. Like, I'll have like a really big character lead, and then out of nowhere, I'm just like, oh, well, I mean, I guess I'll just lose it. You know, I want to make things harder on myself. I want to do things the hard way instead of the easy way. Locks the low. Oh, that could have been really bad for us. And I down tech right into the assist. Not a very good idea. I'll take that 2H. Thank you very much. Then I actually switch into Majin 21 right here. And tech forward. Nice. He just whiffed like five different buttons. He just whiffed like five different buttons right there. I cannot believe what I just saw right there. But then again, I can. But yo, I can't. could not believe him just whiffing that many buttons. Oh god. Can we just not drop combos for once? Oh, that could have been a punish, but you know what? That works too, right? Alright, we're still gonna get the kill here, so that's good. Level one. Into level one. Into the very underwhelming Gogeta 4 level one. Which, this is literally like the only character's fault, I'm not gonna lie. Like, everything else about him is so cool, but that level one. That level one freaking sucks, man. They could have done a way better job with that level one. Ooh, he could have confirmed about that. Alright, I need to slow down here. I tried pressing a button right back, he dropped the combo, so bro thought he was me. We're gonna lose Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. I should have just backed away like I said I was going to. Wait, actually? Yeah, we're gonna get mixed here. Unless. Is he gonna bait on my spark? Yeah, I knew I was gonna live with a pixel. Don't you love using sparking, level one sparking, to save your same character that you tried saving the last game? Don't you love using it a second time and dying with that same character a second time? Don't y'all love it? Don't y'all love it? It's all good though. We gonna take care of Android 18 right there, but my goodness, bro. I tried saving Gogeta 4 a second time, same exact scenario. Let him die after sparking and nearly getting baited into spark bait. Which, again, nearly worked. And I waited for it this time too. The other time I didn't wait for it. But damn, I actually had the overhead right there. Doesn't block the overhead here, and that should finish things up. Literally, hold on. That was literally the exact same scenario I don't remember if it was in this set or not, but I feel like that was the exact same scenario as how the last game ended, but I could be wrong. I know I got a kill in that same exact corner, went for an overhead with Trunks, and did the job, but regardless, we take things 2-0 here, looking pretty solid so far. Could have played a lot cleaner there for the most part, but yeah. If you guys are enjoying the video so far, be sure to hit the like button. Trying to get to 20 likes as I usually set the like goal to. And if you're new here and enjoy the content, be sure to hit the subscribe button on the daily grinders, like I said, and we're going to keep going. So yeah, I'll see you guys for the last set of the video. Back with the next set of the video, and we run it back with Miguel, who was our last opponent, and he switched up the team entirely. Still playing Vegito, but is playing Kefla and Team Gohan. Team Gohan with the C assist at that. Switched it up entirely. I was not expecting that. I was definitely... as soon as I saw his name pop up, I'm like, oh, okay. But he popped up with a completely different team. Maybe he was hoping to run it back with me with a different team. Maybe this is his main team. Who knows? Definitely a completely opposite team as opposed to the team that he was playing before. Damn, I could have punished him because he woke up a flight. Good tech on the Dragon Rush. And we're going to wake up Mash. But yeah, completely different team, throwing me off. Maybe it might work out for him, maybe it won't. Maybe the other team might have been better for him. I don't know what he was trying to press there, but we end up getting the punish because we got the counter hit. And I'm actually going to take the sliding knockdown right here. Still got 3 bars. There it is. I'm hoping to bait something out right there. Like, I don't know if he was going to get a little bit crazy right there and try to DP or do anything, but he vanished right there. Thankfully for us, we were able to punish. And Kefla, a character that, man, I really wish that she ended up being cooler than she actually was. Because for me, I'm not gonna lie, she is kind of boring. She's not as fun as I was expecting her to be when she first released. I was really excited for her when she dropped, but tried to 2-H me right there, but unfortunately whiffed. And I had the hit. You ever just have the hit and not believe in yourself? Yeah, that's me all the time. Nonetheless, though, we end up cleaning things up, and we haven't really switched out to Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta here either. Kind of just been playing the solo show with Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, and down to the Vegito. He seems to keep the Vegito at anchor at all times, which not a bad place to keep him, honestly. He's still like, honestly, he can. Vegito's a character that can literally play like any part of the game. Like, he could be a point, mid, or anchor, which is pretty crazy. I think that's a pretty big deal, not gonna lie. And we're gonna extend this out as much as we can because we got enough meter to kill right here. And damn, I should not have finished it with Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta's level 1, but it is what it is. We're gonna have to take it. We didn't have to watch this level 1, but I did because I did the supers in the wrong order. But nonetheless, though, we end up taking things 1-0 right here. And mostly play that Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta that match. Pretty dominant fashion right there. But yeah, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, honestly, I'm not even that good with this character. I kind of just do the most basic things with him, but he has some really cheap stuff, not gonna lie. And we're gonna take the punish right here. That was kind of awkward, I'm not gonna lie. I know y'all saw that. I was kind of, messed up my hand. Why did we just trade there? Why did we actually just trade there? There was, I thought I was plus right there, because, okay, he didn't bait out a spark. And I'm gonna take that. I didn't get my air dash. My micro dash. That could have been really bad for us. Good command grab by him. Honestly, I would have just taken the sliding knockdown. But had a lot of control to start off this match, but now it's getting a little crazy. Okay, you know what? We're going to take that. I definitely wanted to backdash into the corner and get my JH, but caught him mashing right there. You know what? We're going to go all the way with this. Majin 21 level 1. It's a Gogeta level 3. Will this kill? Wow. Okay, the 2M is gonna kill. Wow. Just barely didn't live right there. Just barely didn't live. Okay. Alright, got the defense. I feel like he's gonna... Literally, I was gonna say, I feel like he's going to Super Dash. And what do you know? He did. He's in sparking and didn't go for a single overhead. You know what? We're gonna take that. That was supposed to be a cross-up. I mean, I would have gotten 2H'd anyways because he kind of saw the cross-up coming, I guess. Okay, random 2H. I know. I thought he was gonna try and go overhead. I'm not gonna lie. But you know what? A hit's a hit, right? Kind of random, I know, but I thought he was going to jump and do overhead right there. I don't know for whatever reason I thought he was going to do that, but he ended up running to the 2H. He's done some pretty random things himself in this match, so you know what? I've earned myself some randomness myself. I don't think that's how it works. I'm rambling. Don't mind me. All right, down to Vegito again. Nice. I definitely thought he was just going to do 5-0. But instead, we're losing out on Trunks when we didn't have to. 7 bars of Vegito. Just level 1 right there. I thought he was going to be able to kill without meter, which would have been big for him. But he's fine. He has more than enough. But for us, let's try and close things out. Okay, there's a super dash. He kind of just came charging at me. Oh, there we go. I should have probably super dashed after that. Maybe I could have. I'm going to take that. We get sliding knockdown mid screen. Oh, we could have punished if we were more patient there. Get that off, man. I thought he was gonna air dash towards me, and I was gonna be able to punish. Okay, but we gonna take that though. That should be the game for us, so long as we don't drop this. It's like I cursed myself. Maybe I shouldn't say anything. Maybe. Oh. Okay. Okay, maybe I shouldn't say anything, right? Maybe I just shouldn't say anything. If I just be quiet, like, and just do what I gotta do, then I'd finish off matches a lot quicker, huh? Jumps right out of there. He could have actually punished me a lot. That's a little crush, and giving the game away, as we normally do. Alright. What if... That just didn't have to happen. That just literally didn't have to happen. I didn't know what he was going to do there, but that just didn't have to happen. But here we are playing game three of something that should have been a 2-0, honestly. No disrespect to Miguel or anything like that, but considering how I dominated in the other games, I should have been able to take care of business, but it'd be like that when it'd be like that. Sometimes you just lose matches that you shouldn't lose, you know what I mean? That's just the nature of the game, it'll be like that. But off to a strong start again, which I got off to in this game, in the last game, got off to a strong start and just slowly but surely gave that away. Got him to spark, which is good for us. Got hit by the second overhead, we'll take that. I still haven't really got in touch ourselves. We're gonna waste the sparking time, go for level 3 here. I'ma actually go low here. Had a feeling they'd probably like expect maybe like a cross up, but we're gonna take that. And so far, looking a lot better. Not gonna lie. So far looking a lot better this game. Kind of like how we were looking like in the previous game, but will we actually close things out for real, and quick too, because that's another thing. I decided to poke right there, because why not? Okay, thankfully we didn't run into the sword, but we ended up dropping that easy-ass conversion that we normally drop, and we finally got hit there. We were looking like we were going to get a perfect here, but... ended up dropping that conversion. Literally the easiest conversion possible. I'ma take that. Thank you very much. And extending this combo out as much as I can. And we gotta take care of things this time around. Took care of things a lot faster this time around. Didn't end up selling that game. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to hit the like button, like I said. And if you're enjoying the content, be sure to subscribe if you're new here. And yeah, that's gonna be the end of the video. I ended up taking things, it was in control for most of the match, but yeah, didn't need to give that last game away, but it's all good. But with that being said though, hope you have a good day and take it easy.